Hello folks, welcome to the channel update. Many thanks to Sean Priest for his generous donation. Like I said, may you be eternally blessed, and what you gave to me, may you receive back many times over. I'd also like to thank everybody else clicking on the videos and watching them. I've currently got 2 subscribers. Thank you very much for subscribing, for seeing the vision of the channel and for your support. Thank you. Now, today I'm going to talk about what I was talking about the other day there, about the secret and the formula that most people sell for funny money on how to live a type of life you wish to live on your terms. That's a bit of a mouthful. So get back DSV exercise with me just now. Take time to think of when you were a child and what it was you wanted to do when you grew up, before life got complicated, before you had all the responsibilities. Your dream, what was your dream? If you're in a job now that you're not spiritually fulfilled with doing, and it's grinding you down and you're not happy and you feel miserable, get back, connect with your inner child, right? Now, I live by this code, right? It's not even a code, it's just a viewpoint in life that I live by. The closer you are to the child inside, is the closer you are to the kingdom of God or heaven, or the closer you are to God, right? Now think about it. We're all children, no matter what age we are, right? You might be a man watching this and think, well, I'm a man and I've got a deep voice and I've got responsibilities and all the rest of it. But at the end of the day, you're still a child, you're living your life, and there's stuff you don't know. There's life to experience and fun to be had, right? Forget responsibilities and seriousness all the time. Apply joy and happiness to your life as often as you can, right? Now, with regards to how you live your life, right? Again, I come at it from this point of view. You can live your life 2 ways, right? I'm 48 and I've narrowed it down to 2 specific ways of living my life. Now you can live life in fear, or you can live life in love, right? Now if you live life in fear, then it will block you from being happy and living a good life, right? If you're worried about what other people are going to say or do to you, or talk about you, if you hand your power over to somebody else and live in a mind state that you're giving your own mind and what you want to do over to somebody else, then that is a bad place to come from, right? Your creator, right? I know some people are not comfortable with God, and I know a lot of people believe in God, but I do. Everybody is put here to experience a good life, Right. Now, I'm not wanting to get too much into it geographically and all that, where there's famines and natural disasters and wars and all the rest of it. But a key plan of the Creator is abundance for everybody, right? Now, you shouldn't be here living your life suffering or being in fear of any kind. You should live your life in love, right? And one of the ways you can do that is by not judging people, right? Don't judge people because it's a reflection of yourself, right? Or mock people, which is even worse, right? See, I mean, I've witnessed this where I live, right? I'm not going to mention any names or whatever. I just see it in people and how they look at me, right? I'm a wee bit overweight, right? I'm not as bad as I was maybe years ago. I was a lot heavier, right? But a lot of people that didn't like me used to say, look at that FB, right? Use your imagination here. Look at that big FB and all the rest of it and cuss me upside down, right? But see, within weeks or months, I would look at these people and guess who would be the big FB, right? Or whatever, right? So don't mock people. Don't judge people. And if you're going to choose love over fear, love unconditionally, right? If somebody does something in life, it's not down to you to judge them, right? You never walked in their shoes. You never lived their experience that led them to do something that you think you can judge, right? You can't judge anybody, right? It's like, again, I'll go back to the Bible quote or whatever, let them without sin cast the first stone, right? Now, a lot of people judge me and I shrug it off, right? I'm like, ah, so what? I don't care. For years, I used to, right? For years, I used to live in fear. But now, I live my life in love. I notice birds. I notice flowers. I notice butterflies, right? Life is good, right? But a lot of people see fit to judge and have a problem with how I live my life. But that's just a wee phase I'm going through just now, where I'm learning to deal better with that. And by highlighting the love and the fear in this update or broadcast to yourself is to help you deal with it. The world reflects back to you what you put out, right? If you concentrate on an outcome or have fear-based thoughts all the time, you'll eventually draw that to you. If you live in love and you put out love, you get love, right? Now, just to finish on, I've got a wee story for you, right? I was in a swimming pool a few years ago, and I was at the side of a pool, and a guy I know was beside me in the pool, and I was doing breaths, right, as opposed to lens underwater, right? It's just, I like being underwater, doing it at the bottom and up, right? But I was doing quite a few of them, and one time I was under, I got a bit frightened because I didn't think I could make it up to the surface, right? And I was, you know, it was a close call. I thought I was going to drown and all that because I had been doing like a few breaths or whatever, right? And the guy was beside me, I don't know if he telepathically sent me this message or I heard him saying it, right? But see, when I was under the water swimming, I was thinking about life and other situations and other people, and I clearly heard, stay in your own head, you'll live longer, right? Now, I've applied that in my life numerous times, and it is amazing, right? It goes back to giving your power up to somebody, right? If you stay in your own head, you're in charge. If you give your power away to somebody else, they're in charge, right? If you feed fear, fear will eat away at you. If you feed love, love will fulfill you, right? And again, because of my spiritualism, I'm just going to give you a wee bit of advice that I heard last week, right? Now, in this adjustment period for some people that are taking on board what I'm saying, to overcome a fear, call upon Archangel Michael, right? Now, you might not believe in angels or whatever, but just try it, right? And get into it, right? You say, Archangel Michael above me, Archangel Michael below me, Archangel Michael behind me, Archangel Michael in front of me, Archangel Michael to the left of me, Archangel Michael to the right of me, protect and guide me through my day, on my journey, right? And then thank them. Thank them then, and thank them after you have a good day. Okay? And just one more thing I wanted to add, because the next upload after this update should be a tour in my town, right? Which I hope a few of you are looking forward to. Obviously not the ones that are from the town, but a wider audience, right? What was that again? Hold on. Hold on. Well, I think that's it. I think that's everything. Right, so that's quite a lot to take in. And if you've made it this far in the video, thanks very much. Like I said, I love you, right? I don't care if people judge me and say, oh, he's this or he's that, because I'm in touch with my emotions and my feelings. I do love people. I don't judge people. I love people as they are. Right, which means I love you, right? So, again, thanks, Sean Priest, and thanks for the subscribers, and thanks for taking the time to view the video. Be blessed.